Welcome to WebStylePress. Consider you are done creating your website. Now you want to add some transition and animations to your website. Without using any library, by using only one line of CSS code, you can animate elements in your website. And you can add cool transitions and effects to your website. Whatever is in sudden movement, you can add transition to it and make it smooth. I will add few elements here and will show you how to add smooth transition effects to these elements. This is my HTML and this is my CSS for main area. And this is the main area. This is a link, a button. This area will change opacity on hover. This area will grow in size. This area will also grow in size. This block will move back and forth. Right, so this is our HTML. This is an anchor, a link, and this is button. And this is the area with class opacity. And here we have got class transition, and inside this class transition we've got a paragraph. Here class transition 2, and inside we have got a class inner. Here transition 3, and inside we have got a div with class inner. So this is our HTML. Now let's take care about CSS. For anchor element, link is blue, at hover it will be red. Button has blue background, at hover it will change to black background. This area will change opacity 100% to half on hover. And this area uses transform scale. Then we've got this area. Its inner has background color black. Its width is 50%. And when we hover over it, its inner will be 100% width. And here we have got this area, and its inner it has background color black, width and height 100 pixel. This is the box, and transform translate x 50 pixels distance from its left position. And when we hover over this, its inner will transform some more. It will move to right. Okay, so this is what we have: link, button, and opacity, and this area grows, and this is some transform. Now see, we have these elements including link, button, one element that is changing opacity, one element that grows, one that moves, and all. Now the transition that they follow is abrupt. We can make this smooth, and we can add smooth transition effect in all of these by using only one line of CSS. Let's target all these elements. We have got anchor, button, element with class opacity, transition, paragraph, transition 2, inner, transition 3, inner. So the actual element that moves or that has got a hover state, that we are targeting. And we are targeting its regular state. And this is that one-liner CSS code. Transition all 0.3 seconds ease. And for ease, we have got more. We have got is in out, ease out. These are seconds. Duration for the transition. And this is CSS property. Here we can have width, we can have opacity, we can have whatever, but I am targeting all CSS properties that are possible here. Save. And now see. Is it smooth now? So use this at regular state of element. In our example, we have regular state of elements and hover state. Don't use it at hover state of elements. Just adding it at regular state is sufficient. Now you can see all animations and transitions or effects at this page are smooth using only one line of CSS code. So this all 0.3 seconds and ease is shortcode of this thing. Transition property all. Transition duration 0.3 seconds and transition delay that I didn't use here. Here we have 0 seconds and then transition timing function ease in out or ease. Transition property all means all CSS properties, be it width, color, transform or whatever. Transition duration is duration of whole transition effect. Transition delay is to add delay from starting the transition. And transition timing function is mode of transition. Let me show you delay. If I add 2 seconds here, then our transitions will start after 2 seconds. See. And here. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. See? If you like to add delay in this short code, you can add it after duration. But I will not use it because it is not needed here. Also, transition timing functions are many. These specify speed curve of transition. So here you can use ease, linear, ease in, ease out, ease in out. And cubic bezier. Ease transition effect with a slow start, then fast, and then end slowly. This is default. And then linear effect transition effect with the same speed from start to end. Ease in is transition effect with a slow start. Ease out effect with slow end. Ease in out transition effect with a slow start and end. And then for cubic bezier, it lets you define your own values. So you can use any of these here. So there you go. Like, share, subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.